Hello everyone, myself Gunjita Kanjolia and I am studying in SBM College of Naturopathy and Yogic Sciences. I'm a final year student and today I'll be taking yoga classes. So in this we'll be learning about asanas and various pranayamas. So we see in this situation of COVID, like there are people who have any breathing problems, or you know, we are going through so much of stress in our day-to-day lives, whether it is of pandemic or any other situation. So what yoga does to our body is it acts on our body physically and mentally and reduces our stress as well as enhances our immunity. There have been several studies conducted in which it is proved that yoga helps in enhancing your immunity. So I guess it is one of a good tool to be used against COVID as well as in battling with the daily stress of our mind. So today we'll be going through certain set of asanas and pranayamas, and I hope you like the session. If you have any doubt or queries, or if you want to ask anything, you can let me know after the session. And also I am taking yoga classes for now. And after taking the yoga classes, I realized that how the yoga and all the sessions and the asanas, the relaxation techniques, the pranayamas has helped individually in getting stronger and, you know, enhancing their spirit and preferably making them happy. So even I'm sure you'll get benefit from the session. So we'll start the session. So we'll sit comfortably in any meditative posture, preferably Sukhasana or Vajrasana, whichever you're comfortable with. Now both the hands in chin mudra. We'll start the session by chanting one round of Omkara followed by salutation to Maharshi Patanjali. Inhale and chant Omkara. Join your palms together. Yogena chittasya padena vacha. Malam sharirasya cha vaidyakena yopakarotam pravaram munina patanjalim pranjaliranatosmin. Rub both your palms together, make them warm. Keep the palm on your eyes and open your eyes by looking at your palms. So we start the session. Everyone, come to standing sthiti. First, we'll start with loosening exercises. Okay, so in loosening exercises, we'll be first starting with our neck movement. That is, we have to inhale and look up, exhale and look down. Inhale and look up, exhale and look down. While exhaling, bending down, make sure if possible you touch your chin to your chest. And people who are having cervical, you don't have to perform any of the forward bending asanas considering your neck, okay? So we'll practice. Inhale and look up. Exhale and look down. Inhale and look up. Exhale and look down. We'll go for side bending. Inhale in the center. And while going towards the right, exhale. Inhale in the center again. And while going towards the left, exhale. Inhale in the center, exhale while bending towards the right. We'll try to touch our ears to our shoulders and make sure you don't raise your shoulders up. Inhale in the center, and exhale towards your left. If you want to give a good stretch, you can hold your hand, you can, with the opposite hand, you can give a nice stretch here to your neck on the side. Now coming to neck rotation, we'll start from the center. Clockwise direction, inhale while going and while coming down, exhale completely. One, two, make sure you inhale as you go up and exhale while coming down. Anti-clockwise direction, one, inhale while going up, exhale while coming down, two, and three, breathe in and breathe out. Slowly relax, relax for a while. Now we'll start with shoulder rotation. For that, make sure you touch both your elbows like this in front. And then while raising your elbows up, you have to inhale and then exhale again while coming down. We'll practice. One, go as slow as you can. Two, three. While going up, we'll try to touch our biceps to our ears. Okay. Four, anti-clockwise. One, two, three, and four. Slowly release your hands and relax. You can perform these exercises for like 5 to 6 counts. In this session, I will be teaching only for 2 to 3 rounds. You can do it as per your convenience. Okay. Now we'll go for another practice, that is trunk twisting. For that, we'll keep our right palm on our left shoulder and our left palm on our, and our left hand. We have to bend at the elbow and keep it on our waist. Okay, so we'll inhale in the center, we'll inhale in front, and while turning towards your back, you have to exhale and look back from the side where you're keeping your hand. And stay there for a while. We'll hold our breath here for 5 counts. Let's say 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Exhale while coming front. Similarly, we'll practice it on the opposite hand. We'll inhale and raise both our hands together. Then keep one hand, you'll keep your left hand on the right shoulder and your bend at your right elbow and keep it on the left waist. We'll inhale here in the center and exhale while going back and hold our breath here. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Slowly exhale and keep your hands in front and release and relax. You can do this practice for 3 to 4 rounds as per your convenience. Now we'll be going for chair pose, or we can say even knee exercise. In this, what we have to do, we'll inhale and raise our hands in front. We'll exhale and bend down and stay here for a while. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Inhale and come up. We'll practice it one more time. Inhale, exhale while going down and stay here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Inhale again and come up slowly and relax. Feel the stretch in your thighs. Feel the stretch in your thighs and hamstrings. Thank you. Now, we'll be going towards another practice, that is Tadasana. So in that, we have to inhale and raise both the hands till shoulder level. Exhale and turn the palm towards the ceiling. Inhale again and clutch both your hands, both your fingers. Then inhale again and raise up. And stay here for a while. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Exhale and come down. Slowly release your hands in the same order and relax. We'll be doing it for one more round. Slowly inhale and raise your hands up. Exhale and turn the palm towards the ceiling. Inhale and clasp both your fingers. Exhale and go up and stay here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Exhale and keep your toes down and hands down in the same order and relax for a while. Close your eyes and relax for a while. Now we'll be going for another practice, that is Vrikshasana. So Vrikshasana is also known as tree pose. Okay. So Vrikshasana, the benefits are mainly it helps in neuromuscular coordination and it improves the alertness and awareness. So how do we practice it? Let's see. First, bend your right knee and keep it on your left thigh. Then we'll focus at a point in the center in front of us. After we are balanced in this state, then we'll slowly inhale and raise both our hands. Exhale and turn the palm towards the ceiling. Inhale again and join your hands and stay here for a while. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Exhale and keep your hands down in the same order and slowly release your leg. We'll practice this similarly on the left side as well. We'll bend at your left knee and keep it on your right thigh. Focus at a point in front of you. After you're balanced in this state, slowly inhale and raise your hand up. Exhale and turn the palm towards the ceiling. Inhale again and join your hands together and stay there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Slowly release your hands in the same order and legs. Relax. Feel the changes in your body after the practice of Vrikshasana. Now, we'll be going for another practice, that is Ardha Chakrasana. Okay, so in this, we'll place both our hands at the back of our waist, and we'll slowly inhale and exhale while going back. So this is how we'll be practicing. Inhale in the center and while going back, exhale and be here for a while. You can stay there for 5 counts as per your convenience. Okay. Then slowly release your hands and relax. This is called Ardha Chakrasana. Okay. In this, there is bending of a spine. There is spinal bending taking place. And people who are having any low back pain, don't practice this. Now, we'll be going for sitting asanas. So for that, we'll all come to Vajrasana. So this is called the sitting sthiti in yoga. The sitting sthiti in yoga is called Dandasana, and this is the posture of Dandasana. Now we'll be practicing Vakrasana. So in Vakrasana, what we have to do is we'll bend at our left knee per se. You have to bend at our left knee. Make sure your spine and your neck is straight. Then we'll bend at our left knee. Inhale and raise your hands up. Exhale slowly and keep your right hand and hold your left ankle or your left toe. And your left hand will automatically go back. And this will be the final position. You can stay in the final position for 5 to 6 counts. And do normal breathing here. Then slowly release your hands in the same order and release your leg. We'll practice the same on the right side. Bend at your right knee slowly. Make sure your spine and your neck is straight. Inhale and raise your hands up. Exhale and keep your right hand back. And your left hand should clutch your right toe. And you will be facing backward. And make sure your shoulder is straight throughout the process. And you can stay here for 5 seconds as well. Slowly release your hands and release your legs and relax. Now we'll slowly lie down in Shavasana with the help of the elbows. Slowly lie down in Shavasana. Your heels should be facing towards each other, and your palms should face towards the sky or ceiling. Eyes closed and relax. Now we'll practice Pavan Muktasana. So for that, bring both your legs together. Inhale and raise your legs up. Exhale and bend at both your knees. Now slowly hug your knees with both your hands. And inhale and raise your neck and head up. And stay here for a while. So 5 counts. 1, 2, 3, 4. And 5. Exhale while coming down. And slowly release your hands. Release your legs in the same order. And relax. This practice is called Pavan Muktasana. You can do it for 3 to 4 rounds. Now we'll be going to another practice that is called Setu Bandhasana. It is also called Bridge Pose. So why it is called Bridge Pose? We'll see that. I'll demonstrate how we practice Setu Bandhasana. So in that, we have to bend at both our knees. Bend our knees. And then with both the hands, over both the hands, you have to fold your heels. Okay? And slowly we'll inhale, and then raise the body up. And make sure the body is straight. It shouldn't be more up or more down. The body should be straight. And this posture looks like a bridge. That's why it is called a bridge pose. My whole body is straight, and I'll hold here for 5 seconds. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Exhale and come down. We'll practice it one more time. Slowly inhale, raise your body up. And hold. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Exhale and come down. And release your legs. And relax. Relax in Shavasana. Now slowly you will come up with your left hand back behind the shoulders, bend at your right knee, turn to your left side and use the support of right arm, come up, we'll go in Vajrasana. Everyone knows that Vajrasana, in Vajrasana, we practice Vajrasana after having food. This is also very good for digestion. And this is the posture of Vajrasana. Your spine is straight, neck is straight, and both the hands are resting on our knees. Now slowly, we'll come to Shashankasana. Inhale and raise your hand back. Exhale and bend down. And release your legs one by one. And come to Makarasana. For Makarasana, we'll cross at both our elbows. And our fingers will be placed on the opposite shoulders and heels will be facing towards each other. Now we'll be practicing Bhujangasana. So in Bhujangasana, I'll demonstrate how to do. Bhujangasana is also called Cobra Pose, okay? So how we'll do is, we'll place both our palms on the side of our chest. We'll inhale slowly and raise our body up till our navel region. Okay? And stay here. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Slowly exhale and come down. We'll practice it for one more time. Inhale and raise your body up to navel region. Hold your breath here. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Exhale while coming down. And relax. Relax in Makarasana. Now we'll be going for another practice, that is Shalabhasana. Okay, so in that we have to keep our hands, we have to make a fist and keep our hands down like this, and your head will be facing forward, and then we have to inhale slowly. You have to inhale slowly and raise both your legs up as much as you can and stay here. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Exhale and come down. And slowly release both your hands and relax in Makarasana. You can practice this for 4 to 5 rounds. Release and relax and feel the changes in your body. Now slowly, bend at your knees and come to Shashankasana. Inhale and come up. Give a nice stretch at the back and come to Vajrasana. Close your eyes here for a while. And recall all the practices done. Feel the changes in your body. And slowly come to Sukhasana. We'll start with Kapalbhati. So for Kapalbhati, you can sit in either Sukhasana or Vajrasana, however style you prefer. I'll be practicing it in Sukhasana. So for that, in Kapalbhati, we have to inhale, and while exhaling, we'll be doing it for 3 rounds, okay? So while exhaling, we'll go for 20 stroke, then 40 stroke, then 60 stroke. Also, if you're a beginner, you can go for 20, 20, 20 stroke. And how we practice is, we'll inhale. Also, one more thing, whenever we practice Kapalbhati, there is no effort in inhalation, okay? So there will be normal breathing, like as you're breathing for now, that similar breathing you have to practice in Kapalbhati while inhalation. But when we exhale, it will be a forceful exhalation. So how it will be, if you are a beginner, you can also keep your hand on your stomach, and while exhaling, we have to make sure that your navel pull back towards the spine, okay? And how it will be, we'll inhale normally, and while exhaling, we'll perform 20 counts. We'll practice together. Slowly relax after 20 strokes. We'll practice second round. Again, 20 counts as well. Inhale normally and exhale. Relax. Inhale for the third round and forceful exhalation. And relax. This is the practice of Kapalbhati Pranayam. So in this, make sure whenever we are standing, neck and our spine is straight, okay? Our shoulders should be gently relaxed and our eyes will be closed. So this was the practice of Kapalbhati Pranayam. Now we'll be going for another practice, that is Shithli Pranayam. Okay. So in Shithli Pranayam, what we do is we'll take our tongue out and we'll roll our tongue like a tube, like a pipe. Okay. So this is how it will come out, and we'll inhale through our mouth and we'll exhale through our nose. Okay. So it will be done like this. We'll sit comfortably in Sukhasana. Both the hands should be in Chin Mudra, like this, resting on your knees. we'll close our eyes and you'll take your tongue out and we'll inhale through our tongue and exhale through our mouth. After practicing, gently open your eyes. So this is a cooling pranayama, okay? Whenever we practice this, you can feel coolness in your throat region. So this is the second pranayama called Shitli Pranayama. Now we'll go for the practice of Bhramari Pranayama. So Bhramari Pranayama is also called Hummingbee Pranayama. In this, what we do is, we'll be sitting comfortably again in Sukhasana. And then we have to perform Shambhavi Mudra, okay? So how we perform Shambhavi Mudra is, you keep your first finger on your eyebrows, second finger under your eyes, third finger on your upper lip, and fourth finger on your chin. And with the thumb, that is with the fifth finger, we'll keep it, we'll close the flaps of our ears. Make sure you close the flaps and not insert your thumb inside the ear. So this is called Shambhavi Mudra. Okay, this is how we'll practice it. And throughout the whole practice, we have to inhale through our nose. And while exhaling, we have to make a humming bee sound. Or you can make the sound of ma. Okay, our mouth will be closed. And I'll just demonstrate once how it will be practiced. And throughout the practice, make sure you focus on the center of your eyebrows, okay? On the Agya Chakra. We'll start the practice. Adopt Shambhavi Mudra. Inhale through your nose and chant Makara while exhaling. Slowly keep your hands down and relax. Recall the sound in your mind. And gently open your eyes. So in Bhramari Pranayam, what I taught is by keeping like this, Shambhavi Mudra, okay? There are different or various techniques of practicing Bhramari Pranayam. At some places, people even tell like keeping your first finger and closing the flaps of your ears, then practicing Bhramari Pranayama. This is also correct. There are various techniques and today we practiced with a different technique. Okay. So I'm really grateful to be a part of this session. And I thank you all for giving me your time and listening and coming here, watching it till the end. I'm really grateful today for teaching you all as well. So as the pandemic situation is going on, I hope this session has helped you in some or the other way. If you have any queries or any doubts regarding the session, or if you want to consult me, if you want to ask any question, you can contact me anytime. My details will be mentioned in the description box. You can contact me through my mail or through my Instagram handle. I've been taking classes for, I started in June and I've been taking classes for a month now. And the response was also very great. So if this session has helped you and if you are really in need of help, definitely approach me. And thank you everyone for having me and giving me your time.